नमस्ते, गुड इवनिंग, वेलकम टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ तुरिया टॉक्स। पर्सनल ब्रांडिंग इज नॉट अबाउट यू, इट्स अबाउट पुटिंग योर स्टैम्प ऑन द वैल्यू यू डिलीवर टू अदर्स। विद दैट नोट, आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट मिस प्रीता दुबे, हु इज विद अस, एंड मैम इज द फाउंडर एंड मैनेजिंग पार्टनर ऑफ सक्सेस विटामिन। मैम, वेलकम टू तुरिया टॉक्स।
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, and it's a pleasure and an honor to be here.
Right. Before we proceed with the show, I wanted to say a few things. Many leaders across the subcontinent have been coached under ma'am's supervision for emotional transformation that leads to professional success. She's also a mentor for women entrepreneurs and run a very successful woman entrepreneurship program, a mentorship program, what we call it. And it is called the Woman Entrepreneurs Academy. With that note, we will discuss this topic: how important personal branding is to become successful in life, no matter whichever sector one sets in. So, welcome to Tuhriya Talks once again, ma'am. I would like to know your views on personal branding, being a personal branding consultant yourself.
So if you ask a personal branding consultant what is her view on personal brand, she's anyway going to say all good things about that aspect, right?
Yes.
At the same time, let's forget for once that I'm a personal brand consultant. Let's look at our lives, let's look at our professions, let's look at whatever we do. I always believe in one thing, that you are a walking business card. So before you can introduce yourself formally to anyone, you know, you give a business card when you introduce yourself to somebody. Now that business card, before even they can take a look at that business card and understand, you know, the value of your success. So that business card probably has certain designation which you are very proud of. But before even they can look at that business card and understand what level of success you have achieved, till the time, you know, you are walking towards them or you are standing at a certain place, they have already formed an opinion about your success by just the way you are, even before you have handed over the business card. So what personal brand basically does is it helps you become that business card, where you do not need a physical business card to hand over to someone for them to now know who you are or how successful you are. It's how you appear, it's how you behave, it's how you communicate, it's how your perception has been created that automatically makes the other person understand, without even going to your profile, just by a look at you, and they probably will understand, oh my God, this person seems to be very successful. So that is what the value of personal brand is, according to me. It opens doors for all kinds of endeavors or all kinds of engagements that you are trying to get into. You want to find yourself a job, you are looking for a client, you're looking for a vendor, you're looking at partnerships, you want that money to come into your business, or you are looking for some kind of funding and you need to, you know, you need investors. Your personal brand will help you open that door. So that is what it is.
Right. If people like you, they listen to you. But if they trust you, they'll give you business, or rather they'll do business with you. So I wanted to ask you, how is developing a personal brand important for one's career path?
All right. So let me give you an example here. There was this client of mine who was somewhere stagnant in a certain role for some time. Okay, so the person was not growing for some reason, not totally a reason which is performance related to that person, but there could be environmental reasons that the person was not growing within the organization. And when we got to work together, and I worked on, and I did my diagnosis, and I understood that where could the problems be. We realized that the person, he was very, very effective in their work. The person was very skillful in their work, and would always be doing the work well, to, you know, exceed kind of the expectations of the organizations. Yet, very few in the top management or the super senior management, the peer, the, you know, that level, the senior management level, very few at that level knew this person. So the person was literally invisible. The person would only go, do his work, do a good job at his work. His supervisor would trust him, would depend on him, because he was a very dependable employee and dependable crew. So all the work would come to him, and with a lot of ownership and responsibility, he will complete the work. But he never put an effort of making himself visible to the organization. He was hailed as a hero in his own department. So the departmental folks, everybody knew that, okay, this man is dependable and, you know, very helpful, and I need to go and learn from him and take help from him, and all that stuff was happening. But for the growth, it's the senior management that takes the decision. Your manager would attempt to promote you to a certain level, and his manager did. But whenever he would present this boy's name for promotion or for growth, they would always like, who is he? Never heard of him, never seen him anywhere, never saw him participate in any event. You know, they don't know him. Whereas there were from other departments, there were these people who were proactive, who were visible, who had developed a personal brand which was pretty well known in the organization. So now if I ask you, if you were that senior manager, and there are two options for you. One, there is one manager who is promoting a member whom you also know, have seen the person's work, and you've heard of him, and there is a perception, there's a visibility that the other person has created. So you know that person. And the other hand, there's another manager who is promoting another person, a team member, and he's saying he's very good and all that stuff, but you don't know anything about it. Who would you trust to give the promotion? My question to you, Sandhya, who would you trust to give the promotion?
The person who works the most. I don't want many smart people in my team, but rather I would definitely want people on whom I can depend. Even if I call him at 1 o'clock at night, or even if I call him on Sunday and say, please, you work on Sunday, but take leave. You have to be very, very ethical in certain approach. You cannot expect people to work all the 7 days, because their creativity would be killed too. That happens in manufacturing, where you try to exploit people. But in service industry, you have to actually pamper people. You have to be very, very loving to them. And if you spoil them, if you be after them, everything will go haywire. And I just wanted to say one thing. We got our best training in ANI. The editor said just one thing, that a doctor kill a patient. Basically, he kills the patients if he's not right in his approach. Similarly, we will kill a brand's reputation if we don't take the interview properly. So same comes to journalism, corporate communications, PR. They are all different sides of the table. They're two parts of the coin. So I think, so one has to be very careful. And I tell people that if you're not happy, if somebody is bothering you, please don't work that day. And one should have such kind of leads. Suddenly you feel that you don't want to work, please go. I believe in flexible models. Work from home has its own challenges. Work from home has its own benefits too.
Oh, it does. It does. Absolutely.
people can balance everything and they can save a lot of time. So even in COVID times, we could see the best branding. McDonald's came with their logo. M was drifted just to show that social distancing. हाथीज वर सेट अपार्ट वो जोड़ी नहीं करने के क्योंकि दोनों हाथी को तो सोशल डिस्टेंस रखना नहीं तो कोविड हो जाएगा. ब्रांडिंग इज अ वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट. ब्रांडिंग इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट एंड आई ऑलवेज टेक क्यू फ्रॉम जोमैटो. आई ऑलवेज टेक क्यू फ्रॉम अमूल. अमूल बोलते हैं कि हम लोग ऑर्डर लेना बंद कर दिए. वो बड़ा झटका लगा. ऑफकोर्स आई डोंट हैव फूड फ्रॉम आउटसाइड बट वो बड़ा नीचे से छोटा सा लिखा हुआ था ऑन द ईव ऑफ 1947. They had their campaign on Independence Day. So you need to think a lot to write such kind of copies. You have to be in a different world. You have to live a very secluded life. You cannot do everything. You have to be you have to be dull, disciplined, and lead a boring life. You cannot get into everything and spoil the world. Right.
Yeah.
Yes. So, ma'am, we all know that a personal brand is the unique combination of skills and experiences that make you who you are. And it is how you present yourself to the whole world. I wanted to say that personal branding is extremely crucial in today's economy, especially that is the selling point of your services. Ma'am, please give us a few tips. How can people adapt to your strategies?
Okay, I lost you there, Sandhya. So you may have to repeat the question. I lost you totally out there.
I am saying that I wanted to ask you, how safe is this personal branding in this digital era?
Personal branding in the digital era?
Digital era,
yeah. All right. This is I think, the most need of the hour in the current world, because something that the pandemic has done is suddenly open the doors of the entire world on us. So now it is no longer that I am known only to this limited set of people with whom I work. Now I have an opportunity to let the entire world know who I am. And so therefore, now that we say is, having your online presence, that is building your online personal brand, is also very important. So I'll give you an example. Most of the professionals, if you are looking for a job, you're looking to grow your career, or you are trying to get your business, or you want to get into partnerships, the entire professional world is on LinkedIn. So first and foremost, it becomes therefore very important that you should be on LinkedIn. In today's world, if any professional ever says that I am not on LinkedIn, that is construed as that you are not very serious about your career. Now, I'm sure you would not want that somebody who is trying to give you a job, the first thing they will do is go through your LinkedIn profile. And if they cannot find you on LinkedIn, and then if you go up and say that, sorry, I'm not on LinkedIn, or I'm not active on LinkedIn, or I do not post anything on LinkedIn, they will presume that you are very happy with whatever comfort zone you've created for yourself, and you do not want to shift from there. Now, that is a perception that you definitely do not want the world to create about yourself. Especially if you want to grow up the career ladder. So therefore, building your online personal brand is very important. Take care of what you post on social media. Take care of the entire content. Be very mindful that whatever you post on social media, it adds to your brand and does not take it away from the brand. So maintaining the digital etiquette is also very, very important. How you present yourself, how do you come online, what kind of posts you do, when you react to somebody else's posts, what's the tone that you use? Are you very aggressive? You're very polite, you're very kind. So all these things create your online digital presence or your online personal brand. And what it helps is that, again, It helps a lot of people know you. It helps a lot of people like you. And it takes a lot of people to trust you. So you are basically that circle of influence that earlier was this much limited. You kind of widen it and make it big and bigger for yourself.
If you, a person, doesn't build a personal brand, someone else will brand it. Definitely, it will not be right. It would be a wrong label. So, ma'am, this is a very, very pertinent question. I'm sure my readers, my viewers will definitely watch it. And when we publish the blog, people will read it. Would you like to share some personal branding strategy with our viewers, please?
Yeah, so understand personal branding works on three aspects. I call it ABC. It's very easy to remember. So remember that, you know, any branding that you work on yourself is on three aspects, A, B, and C. A stands for appearance, B stands for behavior, and C stands for communication. Now, before even you can start working on your personal brand, you have to first be very clear about your purpose and objective in life. What is it that you want to achieve? That is very important. Who are you is very important. In a personal brand, we never recommend that wear a facade or present someone that is not authentic. So you need to anyway present your genuine, authentic self to the outside world. At the same time, you want to create a very positive impression on everyone. You want to influence the other person's thoughts about you. So therefore, the first and foremost thing is work on your appearance. Many a times, like nowadays all the meetings are happening online. Not switching on your video camera for an online meeting goes against you in your personal branding. So you need to always remember that you need to keep the video on. You need to maintain an eye contact through that. You need to have a smile on your face. This is all part of your appearance. You need to dress up professionally. I've also seen in a lot of instances, unless the professional is talking to a client, right, they will always wear some t-shirts and polo necks and all that stuff, which does not give a very professional look to you overall. Even while you are working from home, dress up exactly the way you would have dressed up if you were physically in office. That should not go away. And now once you know that what is your purpose, what is your objective, you need to accordingly work on your appearance. You need to work on your behavior. Not by behavior, I mean the etiquette. That is, and nowadays with the work from home, it has become more like a digital etiquette. For example, you received an email. You may not be able to reply to the email right away because you have other stuff that you are working on right now. And this email probably needs a little bit of your thought and then you have to respond. You don't have to immediately reply to an email. But you can always acknowledge that email to let the other person know that, yes, I have received it. That's digital etiquette. And let them know that I will go through it and I'll respond accordingly. So these small, small behaviors help create a personal brand for yourself. Then comes the communication aspect. The kind of language you use. Do you use a lot of negative words when you communicate? This is not possible, that will not happen, or this is more challenging, or this is very difficult. Do you use a lot of negative words or do you use a lot of positive words when you say it's not a problem at all, or this is doable, I think this is exciting? Do you use such kind of words? Because that again shows that, should I work with you? Will it be fun to work with you? Or are you going to demotivate me? So the more we talk negatively, the people around us get negative. And trust me, no one likes to work with anyone who is very negative. You may not be a negative person, but if you always say words that are negative, the other person will perceive you as negative. So therefore, so these are a few things. Obviously, personal brand varies from person to person. It's very unique. So giving you something which is very generic will not help you. But as I said, but there are still a few aspects that you need to keep in mind, like dressing up properly, neatly, maintaining a certain behavior, especially in the digital world, maintaining the digital etiquette, know about them, read about them, and follow them. Let the world know. Whether the other person follows it or not does not matter, but you follow. And the third aspect is about communication. Be very mindful of the language that you are picking up, the tone in which you are talking to people, even the business communication that you are writing, that has a tone. So be very mindful of the kind of language and the sentence formation that you are doing, because whether you're using an active sentence or a passive sentence defines the tone of the entire communication. So be very mindful of these few simple things, and gradually you'll be able to create a brand for yourself. After that, using of social media, use them to your advantage. There are a lot of, again, you'll be able to read a lot of stuff on how to use social media to your advantage, in that will help you in creating your personal brand.
Right. Ma'am, what is your analysis, SWOT, on Puriya Talks and Puriya Communications?
Okay, now this is this is an interesting question. I think your Puriya Talks, on Puriya Communication, the work that you do on Puriya Communication is something which is very, very interesting, because, and especially for, I will talk this on behalf of the entrepreneurs. Now, most of the entrepreneurs, and you are also the similar line of helping the entrepreneurs build their digital brand and, you know, help them create that kind of a presence. And so many entrepreneurs are quite ignorant on how do I use the digital media, you know, how do I use the social media, how do I create my digital presence, and how therefore I can grow via the digital presence. So I think what you're doing through the Puriya Communication is very, very helpful for the entrepreneurs, because they can really benefit if they do not themselves know how to utilize this and grow, and if they do not have the time also. Many times we do many things, taking this additional work on us of marketing ourselves, of, you know, creating our digital branding and using our digital communications also on our head. Then what happens is this takes a lot of time. I have done this, so I'm telling you, therefore it takes a lot of time. Whereas I need to, as an entrepreneur, need to focus more on strategy, on talking to new customers, on converting new customers, and investing time more on them. So I think you're taking that headache away from the entrepreneur. So that's an interesting work, and I would recommend every entrepreneur to look at the digital communication aspect, to always outsource it to someone like yourself, so that we are able to focus as an entrepreneur, they're able to focus on things that are more important, strategically more important for them.
So I that is to share some secret that I don't manage my own social media now. From last 2 years, people do manage it, and you have to trust. So whether somebody is appointing a vendor or whether somebody is appointing a colleague or an employee, you have to trust them. They cheat you, they are burning the bridges, not me. So I think, so as we fall down, we should have the capacity to get up and run again.
Again, okay, good, very good.
Yeah, I think that is the only mantra, yeah. Yes. So with that note, I think we can wrap up this session.
Thank you so much, Sandhya.
I want to say something, ma'am. Yeah. So there is so much one can learn from your achievement, journey, dedication. Of course, I have not mentioned what ma'am has done. So in fact, it was too long a bio. So in case my viewers would like to know a bit more about Ms. Pritha Dubey, they can definitely visit her LinkedIn profile. She has a website too. And in fact, if you wish to get some ideas and consultancy, you please get in touch with her. It would be definitely a best experience. I wanted to say that it is a pleasure having you on board today. And it was, the discussion was inspiring, wholesome. I'm sure people will learn a lot and they would implement it. So definitely we discussed how important personal branding is to become successful in life, no matter whichever sector one excels in. So with that note, thank you, namaste. Keep on writing to us to know more, and you can suggest guests to us. Be safe and namaste.
Thank you.